So we are about to take a train ride up into a little rainforest town. We are super excited to go through the forest, travel back in time.
Yeah, this train is 130 years old. So here's the station behind us. We'll obviously show a video of when the train arrives, and we're really excited to get on. Once we get on the train, we'll hear more about the history and the little towns that we pass through, which we'll share on our journey, but we're really excited. And yeah, look at this trip back in time.
We will climb approximately 1 meter in every 50 to an elevation of 327 meters. By the time we reach Kuranda, we will have traveled through 15 tunnels, over 55 bridges, around 98 curves, and through 153 counties.
Having a beautiful morning, but just had a moment of frustration and annoyance really with ourselves. Obviously we are looking to fight back against plastic, and they came and it's a nice fancy cart, and they said, oh, we're going to offer you tea and coffee, and we assumed that it was going to come in nice teacups or mugs. So another reminder and lesson to always ask what it comes in, because we have a travel coffee cup. So stupid, but it's an important lesson learned, and that's how we're going to take a positive out of it. That just a good reminder to ask.
We will soon enter a 180-degree turn called Jungara Loop, which is also known as Horseshoe Bend. This curve was built up above the surrounding terrain to allow trains to build speed for the ascent ahead.
What do we have?
After the entering Stony Creek Station. During construction, Stony Creek was a thriving township with several amusements. Stony Creek Station was an important stop for early steam locomotives to take on water to complete the climb to Kuranda.
That was the only place with two trains this way.
Bridges in the world. This bridge is the tightest curve on the Kuranda Range. It is built on an 80-meter radius and provides a spectacular view of the famous Stony Creek Falls. As we approach the bridge, look to the right for a great photo of the bridge, then quickly look across to the left for another great photo of the waterfall. After your carriage crosses the bridge, look back and you may be able to obtain another great photo of the falls. In 1890, then Governor of Queensland even had their wives and children with them. It was hard work for the men and a hard life for all. During the next few minutes, our train will pass through a series of short tunnels. Imagine the difficulty of digging these tunnels using just picks and shovels. To add to the hardship, the men had to supply their own tools if they wanted a job. All tunnels and cuttings were dug with picks and shovels after dynamite or gunpowder was used to loosen the rock. Around 2.8 million cubic meters of earth was moved by hand during construction of this railway. Till 1958, the Barron River was a raging torrent, but since the construction of Tinaroo Dam, the water has been contained and used for irrigation purposes on the Atherton Tablelands. However, when the Barron River is in flood, an enormous volume of water gushes over the falls and drops 265 metres, creating a spectacular eruption of water and mist.
Well, we're just wrapping up a beautiful walk here in Kuranda, the rainforest along the Barron River. We walked through the markets, we took an epic train ride, a historical train ride, and now we're just enjoying some scenery before we have to jump back on the way back down. Toot toot. Toot toot. One interesting fact that really struck with me is the fact that this village was built because of the gold rush. Gold was found here and people flocked to the region. They built forts and little towns on the way up here, and because it was so dense with rainforest, there was so much disease and rain and snakes and everything, it was too dangerous. They needed to get a safe way up here, which is why they built the railway. And one out of every 50 people that was part of this, of building this railway, died. Think about that, one out of 50 people. And it was all mainly immigrants coming out to make a living. And the fact that it was in the, you know, 1870s, 1880s, 1890s, think about people coming out to Australia to build a new life, the way that so many people had just jumped across the Atlantic to build a new life in the States. The journey, as we would have seen in an earlier episode, to get from Europe to Australia by boat, to go around Africa and across basically two separate oceans, to get to the eastern side of Australia, is just an epic long journey. And then to get here, to have no money, to be able to figure out a way to live, and one opportunity is to dig a tunnel with a pick here in the rainforest, where you've got, you know, a 2% chance, 2.5% chance of dying. So pretty crazy. And you just really try to transport your mind and feel what it would have been like back in those days, or at least that's what I try to do, to try and gain a new perspective of what we're doing here, why we're here, and how lucky we are to be able to take the train, and how many thousands of people have done so over the last century. So just a point to reflect and appreciate while we're here. Thank you.
Bye.